I'm just telling you how you can stop the spears in the Nightmare of Madness. Let's go ahead and go there right now. A lot of them you may know right when you get here. I'm gonna get something equipped just so I don't die. You'll come out here. You'll see that light up. And that will happen. And you see that little frenzy meter lit up. Which, it kills the enemies too. But it does kill you as well. And again, I won't let you see that. These things are annoying. What I do, I always run fastest. Always keep sedatives equipped. If you don't know where to get sedatives, you can buy them from the shop. It's either the Insight shop. I believe it's the Insight shop. To this area, open these two doors, and once you do that, there's gonna be spiders, so I like to go this way. Run that way, then I wanna run this way. And there is an NPC up here. Alright, I died. Because I see with all those spiders. And as you saw towards the end, you saw that window light up. That's where the spears are coming from, and I'm gonna tell you how you stop them. I haven't even done this yet, but you wanna go ahead and see them. Those are the spears I'm talking about. That's basically all that was like, showing you what those do. And let's go ahead and go to the chip lantern after you defeat Mikolash, the host of nightmares. Also, if you want to get the third and final moon rune, which if you don't know what that is, it basically is you acquire more blood echoes from fallen enemies that you kill. As you see, I have that equipped, that first red one, that is the last. More echoes from slain enemies. Also, look at those weapon stats. Beautiful, beautiful. Yes. Anyway, so once you're here, after you defeat the guy, Mikolash, you're gonna wanna come up here, but you're probably gonna get invaded. If you haven't completed this area, you're gonna probably get invaded. Most likely. And you wanna come to this elevator right here. And hop on in it. And then what you're gonna wanna do is, I even failed at this before. Like that. Alright, I died. Let's try that again. Take two. All right, ready? Let's go. Get this elevator, and you kind of want to line yourself up like this. I think it might be the best way to do it. And then just jump in that little window. Open this chest if you want. Grab the Inflictorian, and what you want to do is run. You're not going to get frenzied in this area. Well, you might if you get hit by those guys. As you see, I just get frenzied because I ran into, but this is the part you really can get frenzied on. Alright, so once you see that, you want to run in here. You can kill those spiders if you want. I mean, they're not bugging me, so I ain't gonna kill them. As you see, they're not even following me. You want to run to this lever. And you want to pull it. And you're going to see a cutscene. Spoiler alert right now. Just heads up. It's going to drop Mother Brain down into that area. Where if you have this gesture that you get from the Upper Cathedral Ward, you're gonna be able to get the third moon ring. But I already have it, so I'm gonna go ahead and get my other gesture I had on. Alright. So go ahead and get this one. Drop down here. You mate. Alright, I'm trying to find my way around, to be honest. I'm gonna go ahead and reawaken. I'm probably gonna die right when I reawaken, but once you pull that lever, that's what you want to do. It's the best thing is to reawaken. Alright, so from here, I'm gonna teach you how to get to Mother Brain. Alright, go back to Margo's Loft Middle. Come across this bridge. Go down here and then keep going straight. Follow the path that I'm taking for the best luck of success. Well, actually, this path will directly lead you to Mother Brain. I'm going to show you exactly how you got her down and exactly how you get to her. Follow the path. Now you could have went to Margo's Loft base if you wanted to. That's probably the easier way to do it. But I'm telling you how to get there from Margo's Loft Middle. So come in here. Drop down. The reason I said that is because that's where that lantern is. Would have saved us a lot of work. Come in here, pull this lever if the elevator is not already down. My beer. Send it down if you want. Now follow the path I did. Legit, these enemies really rarely attack. Like, yeah. So anyway, follow the path I do. And go into this cage. Once you're in this cage, you're gonna lower down into the abyss. And you're gonna see this terrifying thing. Very terrifying thing. Just look at this thing. It does not attack. But just look at it. Look at this ugly thing. Anyway, so that's that. I'm gonna go ahead and quit my cannon again. Alright, so if you want that moon rune, what you wanna do is do this in front of her for 30 seconds or until it gives you the moon rune, which it will. It won't probably give me it, since I already have it, but it may give me some notes, I don't know, I've never tried this. But just keep doing this. Just keep doing it. Don't worry, it will come. For you guys, it might. But for me, I already have it, so it's not gonna do it. You can. As you see, that's when you would get the moon rune. I'm gonna pay my respects to her before I die, then I'm gonna kill it. Yeah, I know it sounds like a dick move, but I have to get paid. What am I gonna do? Stab myself. Quit that and fire away at this bitch. Which, as you see, does not do nothing. So what I'm gonna do is get bolt paper, come right in her eyeball, just drag her health down to nothing. She will legit not attack you. She'll just stand there like nothing's going on. You could do ultimate charge attack like this. Or whatever attack you want. She is pretty difficult to kill. But she won't attack back, that's the thing. So the only thing you have to worry about is how long it takes to kill her. Although this thing looks innocent and harmless, I'll step back right now and show you guys that it doesn't attack you. Let's just see. doesn't do nothing. If you kill her, that will happen. Yes. That just happened. Next, you can go back up into your, go back up in the elevator. Or you can just use what I'm gonna use. Bold Hunter's Mark, yes. Where you will reawaken into, this area. And just to prove to you guys, real quick, that it does work. Excuse me, guys. Alright, I'm gonna go ahead and return my weapon real quick. Put the nut, they just gave me. Refit all my weapons. So once you do that, come here, go to Nightmare of Nemesis, and you guys are gonna notice something awesome. And the reason you may want to do this is because maybe you're trying to clear out the area and not get frenzied, but you still have to deal with the enemies. Alright, if I come out here, no frenzy. You do have these guys though, but these guys are fairly easy to kill them. And then they have those worms that jump out of them, which I'm not even gonna kill. But I'm gonna go ahead and explore this area since I've never done it ever in any of my playthroughs. How do I guess you want to shortcut to the one point? The one thing? Come here and boom, you get the checkpoint. Oh, you're gonna throw rocks at me. So I'm gonna run past these guys, even though you could kill them. Actually, I might kill them. Yeah, I'm gonna kill them one by one. Since they are pretty easy to kill. Pretty easy. But they do lots of damage. They dropped 21,000 souls. And they do some damage. So, yeah. You get the iron. One of the irons. By doing this. Knock them off the cliff. Alright, that's what this is. Over here, in this area. Area. Ooh. Oh, never mind. Sometimes these guys will drop twin bloodstone and bloodstone chunks. According to my knowledge. But, that's my experience. But I do have... Do I? No, I don't. I took off my iron for another room. Take out these guys. Just so you guys saw how easy they were to kill. And make your way into the Nightmare of Madness. Now, if you guys did kill the wet nurse, you don't gotta worry about invasion. Is it the invasion? And I could kill these worms. Or leeches, whatever they are, I don't even know. But my weapon does not even work on them. Hardly. So take them out if you want, or just... I think they are weak to electricity.
Yeah, they are.
Very weak to electricity. Alright. So, I'm gonna continue making my way through this area, looting it. Turns out cold blood. Check every crevice and corner you can. And the reason I'm doing this is so if I ring my sinister bell, I can invade and go all the way up to this part where most players won't be. Just because of controversial. Yeah, so if I want to ring my signature bell, I can do it all the way up here, and they'll be all the way down there, and I have the advantage of them, of enemies on my side, even though these enemies can be tricked into fighting anyone, not these guys, and I believe the other guys can too. So... anyway, let's keep on exploring this area while we have the chance. I mean, my view on it is I died. Alright, so I'm back. But that's mainly the main reason how you do it. See you guys in the next video. Thank you for watching, and like, comment, and subscribe.